The United Nations General Assembly has just passed a resolution condemning Israel for using, quote, excessive, disproportionate, and indiscriminate force during the recent clashes at the Gaza border. The Assembly is now calling on UN Chief Antonio Guterres to recommend a so-called international protection mechanism for Palestinian territory. Israel and the United States are, of course, coming out against this vote, claiming the resolution shows clear support for Hamas.
The nature of this resolution clearly demonstrates that politics is driving the day. It is totally one-sided. It makes not one mention of Hamas, who routinely initiates violence in Gaza. Such one-sided resolutions at the UN do nothing to advance peace between Israel and the Palestinians. Everyone recognizes that. But advancing peace is not the goal of this resolution. I suspect even my Turkish friends know the passage of this resolution won't change anything, but that it looks good for the people back home to think they're doing something. That is pure politics.
A vote for this resolution is a vote for Hamas.
More than 120 Palestinian protesters and militants have been killed by Israeli forces in a series of riots along the Gaza border since March 30th. Hamas officials have pushed for Palestinian protesters to breach the security fence and infiltrate Israel, all as part of the March of Return, a riot that coincided not only with Israeli Independence Day, but also with the movement of the U.S. Embassy from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem. Israel has defended its right to defend its border, saying that the IDF will take whatever measures are necessary to protect the Israeli people. At least 50 of the Palestinians killed in the riots have been identified as Hamas militants by the terror group itself. That's why Israel claims that those who support this latest UN resolution are essentially supporting Hamas. The U.S. attempted to amend the resolution with a paragraph that would have condemned violence by Hamas, but that move was struck down.
Our amendment rightly condemns Hamas's indiscriminate firing of rockets into Israeli civilian communities. It accurately condemns the diversion of aid and resources from civilian needs into military infrastructure, including terror tunnels used to attack Israeli citizens. It justly expresses our grave concerns about damage done to border crossings that are hindering the delivery of desperately needed food and fuel to the people of Gaza.
The UN General Assembly, as per usual, doesn't seem to be listening closely to Israel's concerns. The General Assembly passed the resolution with 120 votes in favor and 45 abstentions. The U.S., Israel, Australia, Micronesia, the Marshall Islands, Nauru, Togo, and the Solomon Islands were the only eight countries to oppose it.
The draft resolution before the Assembly is intended to contribute to de-escalation of the volatile situation, to deter violence against civilians, and to promote consideration of measures to protect Palestinian civilians. This process begins with a request to the Secretary General to submit a report in this regard, including, inter alia, recommendations regarding an international protection mechanism.
The resolution is non-binding, but it has asked the UN chief to report back within 60 days on ways to ensure the safety and well-being of the Palestinian people.